الحمد لله وحده، والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده وآله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، under the authority of Abdullah ibn Umar, may Allah Ta'ala be pleased with both of them, he said, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam enjoined upon us zakat al-fitr in Ramadan, a sa' of dates or a sa' of barley upon the free and enslaved, the males and females, and the young and elder from the Muslimin. The hadith is agreed upon. So the measurement for the zakat al-fitr is a sa', which is equivalent to 3 kilograms or about 7 pounds. And it should be given from the food of the people, whatever is common. Dates, barley, raisins, dried yogurt was common during the time of the Prophet ﷺ. Today, if a person was to give rice, lentils, fava beans, and so on and so forth, that would be acceptable as well. The person who has to give zakat al-fitr is a person who has what satisfies his needs the night before al-Eid and the day of al-Eid. Whatever he has more than that, he must give zakat on the behalf of himself and the behalf of those who depend on him. And there is many wisdoms behind this. First and foremost, it is a means of purification from any shortcomings that happened during fasting. Also, it satisfies the needs of the poor and needy from begging on the day of Eid. It also brings joy and happiness to them. Under the authority of Ibn Abbas, may Allah Ta'ala be pleased with both of them, he said, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam enjoined upon us zakat al-fitr in Ramadan as a means of purification from any idle and obscene talk and to feed the poor. So we see clearly the wisdom behind this. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us our zakah, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.